Tonight we're with Sister Lenice Williams. She coordinated Vehicle Day for Bethel No. 2 Apostolic Pentecostal Church. Ms. Williams, what gave you the idea of doing Vehicle Day?
We recently started a youth group at Bethel for children ages 10 and under. And every month we have a theme lesson. This month was community. So we talked about community and services and goods that you can get from the community. So the event that we wanted to host this month to go along with the theme lesson was a vehicle day where the children could see different community service vehicles and talk with the community service representative about the vehicle and how it helps them get their jobs done.
Oh, great. Okay. And I seen you had a Metro bus out here and the kids seemed to love it.
Yes.
They love getting into the driver's seat. The children were excited to hear the fire truck sirens and so forth.
Yes.
And maybe that would kind of give them an understanding that when you're a fire officer, if I say that right, when you're a fire officer, that your time is not your own and that you actually have to go when it's just time to go.
Yes.
And that kind of reminds me a little bit about Christ, how our time is not our own. And when Jesus said to go do something, we need to go do it.
Yes. We don't belong to ourselves when we give our lives to Christ. It's just like being in the military service. You know, once we give ourselves over to the military, your life is not your own, it's the government's. The same happens with Christians. Once we give our lives to Christ, we are no longer ours. We are at the disposal of Christ and we have to do what he gives us to do or we won't be pleasing in his sight.
Okay, great. Now, can you tell me a little bit more about what LIFE is about, what it stands for and so forth?
Yes. LIFE is the acronym for our children's group for ages 10 and under. It stands for Little Ones Impacted for Excellence. And what we're about is taking the little child, because the Bible says train them in the way they should go, and making them a total human being. Learning more about the natural as well as the spiritual, so they will be armed for excellence in any capacity.
Great. Now, is this open just for the church member children, or is it open to the public, or how does that work?
Anyone can come and join LIFE. To join LIFE, all you have to do is to participate and meet the requirements, which are be a child age 10 and under. And you have to have an adult who will drop you off and pick you up. For members, we already know one another because this is a community that we're used to seeing. All they have to do is just sign their children in and out. For members who do not, or people who do not attend Bethel, your children are still free to come. We just would need a valid phone number to contact you once you pick them up. And if the same person that dropped them off would pick them up, we greatly appreciate it. But we also will make other arrangements for another person to pick them up. But a photo ID will be required for them to pick that child up.
Oh, yes. Now, is there a limit as to how many children you can accept? So is it like a first come serve basis, or how does that work with you?
LIFE turns no one away. We will, if we get too big for the arena which we are using, which is our dining hall at Bethel, then we will find somewhere else to house the meeting. But at this point, the dining hall capacity is near 100. So until we get to that capacity, we'll worry about it. We won't have to worry about that. But no, LIFE will turn no young child away. A mind is a terrible thing to waste.
Okay, now you say that no one be turned away, but do you have the required staff to meet the amount of children that will come in?
At this point in time, we have the ratio to have 25 children per meeting session. And that's for preschool standards, even though school age standards are much more laxed. If we need to acquire additional manpower, we will acquire additional manpower because we don't want to turn any child away. For any child who wants to be enriched, we want to enrich them. So we will recruit and leave no stone unturned until we find what we need to meet the goals of who we need to service.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Sister Lenice Williams. Thank you very much for Vehicle Day. I know my children enjoyed it, and I'm sure the other children did as well.
Thanks.
So, do you plan on doing this annually, or?
Yes, we are looking to make this an annual event. It had great popularity with the children. And there are a lot of vehicles that can be serviced. We don't have to have the same vehicles come out every year. So, yes, next year, bigger and better.
All right. Well, thank you very much, and you have a blessed day.
You too.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.